come to the next segment, which is the community panel. Let's set the stage for the community panel while I introduce. So you know now what happens in the app. So what we're going to do now is to bring the women who are constantly engaging and interacting on the app, who are part of communities, who run things on their own, to come up on stage and share their stories. It's a panel discussion about women sharing their journeys of growth within the SHEROES community. We have Kanika Khayabri. She's a blogger, vlogger, content writer, community manager, and founder of Mommy Speaks. Her journey as a content writer and blogger started after she attended a SHEROES meetup. As a community manager, she tries to bring out inspiring stories of women. We also have RJ Stuti, winner of the prestigious India Radio Forum Best RJ Award. She's an RJ with Fever 104 FM, film critic and political satirist with The Quint, and a celebrity chat show host with Hindustan Times. Her alter ego, Pummi Kaur, is equally popular as she lays threadbare political and social happenings with a characteristic wit and humor. Swarnima Bhattacharya, an early adopter of the SHEROES app, she's the founder of the A-Care Women's Health Companion and the curator of Femicon, the country's first women's health festival. Shalini Sharma, founder and creative collaborator at MyMu, seasoned recruitment expert and social media hiring consultant for 12 years with Violet Online Inc., mother of two ventures and one son. Hardcore believer in business through value creation, she's an active SHEROES member and active on Baby Go Go, and she starts up communities where she posts actively products from her venture, which is also partnered with a large number of homemakers in Himachal with weaving skills to make their products. Shalini herself is from Himachal and takes pride in mobilizing the community model. So can we have up on stage our community members joining us for this conversation? And to steer this conversation, of course, I'm going to invite on stage Sairi Chahal. Please put your hands together for these SHEROES who are true, true SHEROES, online, offline.
Thank you. All right, thank you.
Slightly high.
No. All yours. Are we all here? Do we have one more person? No. That's it? Namita? Is Namita in the room? Oh, please come. Sorry. Come on, ladies! Yeah. All right. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Delighted to have each one of you here. I've had the privilege of meeting most of you. Stuti and I spoke a few days ago, but most of you have been part of our journey, and so have you been, I know, from various perspectives. So the idea of putting this panel together is connecting the dots. I think communities are slightly amoebic in nature, and they're not hierarchical. So we find different roads into communities, and we learn different things from our own communities. Swarnima, I'm going to start with you. You set up a healthcare community of your own, and you've been part of the narrative as well. And I think you're really a very strong evangelizer of what you believe in. You know, so give us a little sense of where you come from and what your journey's been like.
So thank you, first of all, Sairi and SHEROES for having me here. I'm really glad to be here. I run a women's health platform called Thea Care. And I have participated in a lot of SHEROES activities on your app. And what has happened is that, you know, the reason I believe in community building is because, first of all, women need safe spaces. Women need spaces which are exclusively for them, where they can ask a lot of questions without really being shamed, being censored, or being told that, hey, this is not appropriate. So, especially with women's health, I have been very passionate about this because I feel that it's time to marry women's health with technology, because it's time for women not just to be netizens and not just to be active users of the internet, but it's also time for us to own technology. And healthcare is a space that I'm, you know, especially passionate about, Because, you know, we as humans have benefited a lot from technology. But how have we as women exclusively benefited from it? Those examples shrink down phenomenally. And I think that was the reason why I believe not only in community building, but also community transformation, where, for instance, if we are a group of 400 women sitting here, then how do each one of us become ambassadors and evangelists of our own accord and talk about community building in our own little ways, whether it's with women in our family, whether it's women in our workspace, and how do we mobilize and catalyze change in our personal ways? So I think that's what my personal investment in this idea is. And
yeah. I can't help but look for John in the room when, you know, women and healthcare is being talked about. But I think an absolutely emergent behavior from users and from where we can go. Kanika, you have many SHEROES connections of all sorts. Unravel a few for us.
So as I sit here, I feel that life has taken a full circle. My journey of entering into content writing, blogging, videos, all started after I attended a community meetup with SHEROES. And yes, it requires a huge round of applause for SHEROES. So we go long back. I was telling Sairi also that. And I feel SHEROES has helped me build a base, which I've capitalized on. And every time I've had any query pertaining to, any career advice I've always wanted, I've always come back to SHEROES. And as Sairi's rightly told me, that if you want something, ask. This is what the community stands for. If you want something, ask. Leave aside all your fears. You may have 10,000 things in mind before putting up that question. But if you do, you will know that there is somebody listening and you will get answers to those queries. And I actually got the help from SHEROES because I made my own platform by the name of Mommy Speaks. And it's a small women's community again, which I've built. The idea behind Mommy Speaks was, as a woman, we've all heard that motherhood is the most natural thing which happens to women. And nobody really talks about the challenges and the struggles which one has to go through. And after I became a mother, I understood that there are a lot of things that are not the way it's told to you. They are very difficult once you become a mother. So I started making videos, I started writing, I started making blogs of my real stories. And to my surprise, there were so many women who came back to me with so much love and appreciation because they could relate to most of the stories. And I've been very vocal about all the challenges which I faced after I became a mother, and they could relate with that too. So then I slowly moved on to bringing out very inspiring voices of women on my platform. And that is when the idea behind bringing that was, I wanted my fellow community members to get inspired by their stories. So I interviewed one of SHEROES again, because life takes a full circle, and I had to come back to SHEROES because that is where it all started. And I interviewed a jewelry artist, I interviewed a social activist, and there were a lot of people from my community who wanted to get in touch with them because they were getting so inspired by their stories. So the entire intent behind starting my platform was, it's as if things were falling in place. And today I have a lot of brands also which I'm attached with. There are a lot of parenting platforms that I'm attached with. And I feel the stimulator in all of this was SHEROES. And the fact that I sit here today as a panelist and share my story, it just, reinstates the fact that what a community can do to you. This is what a healthy community does to you. And my undeniable love for SHEROES has just, increased manifolds after they asked me to come and share my story. So yeah, it's
a
huge round of applause for SHEROES again. And I feel it's important for us women also to leave our fears aside and come forward and ask. They are here to listen and they will answer to all your questions. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kanika. And I'm sure there are a lot of people who are watching you right now who are literally making like a plan in their head to say, I'm going to go back and do this today.
That's the idea.
That's the whole idea. Shalini came and met me a couple of weeks ago, but it was the first real world meeting, but we've had a lot of virtual meetings online. And Shalini is an entrepreneur who's now doing something really cute. Shalini, tell us more about your entrepreneurial venture.
Thank you for having me here. And I really like the way you said, I'm doing something very cute. This has been never said before. So the venture that I am into now, through which I actually got onto SHEROES app, is called Mumyu India. And this is my second venture. This is something which I'm doing. It's entirely business, but I'm doing it to create value for those women who are worth much more than what they're getting right now. And it's just a platform where I'm creating opportunities for them. And also to prove a point, which I would like to, I'll use this platform for this. You know, a point that, you know, every women-led business or every women-focused organization or women-focused initiative is not a welfare project. This is what I really want to put forward. Anything which you do for women, whether it's a CSR activity in corporates or whether you do something for women specially, doesn't have to be a welfare project. Women, do we really need welfare? I really don't think so. So whatever I'm doing for the women back in Himachal, just to tell you, we are right now at a place where we have the potential to actually get associated with highly skilled women in Himachal by 2019. And the numbers I'm talking about is more than a lakh. And right now we are, thank you. Right now we are squeezing ourselves till we have almost 382 women on board. And they are not there because we are giving them a platform. It's not that they need us. It's that it's mutual. They are highly skilled. And being from the recruitment industry, from the skill industry, I have now, after 12 years, realized that, you know, if you really want to associate and to collaborate with someone, skill comes first. So these women are not a welfare project for me. These are my highly skilled, trained professionals who are my partners. So what do we make? We make very cute products for kids, infants, 0 to 1 years. And we make maternity wear and nursing wear. And I'm sure by the end of September, you all will be able to buy it. Most of it is already pre-launched on SHEROES app. And I really thank Sairi and SHEROES for this. Why? Because the women that we are associated with, almost 40% of it is above the age of 60. And 80% of these women are not educated beyond class 5. But they are earning damn good money. So thanks to SHEROES for giving them that platform and that recognition. That's it.
Thank you so much, Shalini. That's so inspiring, and more power to you. May that lack multiply into many, many more.
Thank you. That's all I need.
Women. RJ Stuti, you and I had this cute chat. But I think one of the aspects that communities do to us is each one is an influencer, and you're an influencer in a big way because you kind of seed thoughts in minds of people. You're able to craft narratives. I'd love to hear more from that, and of course from, you know, also your journey with the medium and outside of that, and how do you sort of view being at such a important position, but also in terms of the impact that your work can create.
Thank you. I just want to start by saying I'm loving the view from here because I haven't seen so many women, so many pretty women in one place. I was from an all-girls college, and after my common room there, this is the only time I'm seeing so many women. So I'm really happy, very excited. You know, there's something, and I was telling you yesterday, you know, there's something about this word community. I love it. It's very empowering. It's very intimate. And it just gives you a feeling like there are people there to support you. In the profession that I'm in, we, you know, I'm an RJ. I have a regular show. on Fever 104, and I'm a film critic. My work entails that I interact with people, which also means that I negotiate all kinds of stereotypes and all kinds of notions on a daily basis. And I cannot say, what is this, and turn my face away. I have to interact. I will have to get them to the talking table, as it were, and speak to them from a place where they also understand that. So, of course, you know, as an RJ, it's just, you know, your voice which does the talking, quite literally, till the digital medium kind of put a face to it. But I really like it when others describe what my job does, like you said, sowing seeds of thought. I feel very important then. But actually, that is what it is. And I try not to think about it because it gets, you know, it gets very unnerving then. Radio is a very intimate medium. And part of our training is that when you talk, you must feel that the RJ is speaking to only you. Okay, if I succeed to do that, I'm doing my job right. I'm not an MC, I'm not speaking from a stage, I'm speaking as your friend to you. And so, as a female RJ, what does it mean to be doing a show and talking to so many people who, like I said, have so many notions? It is to find the shero in each one of them, quite literally. And this is very gender not specific. So, as radio programming, we're told, acha, you're a female RJ, afternoon show, talk about recipes, okay? Talk about recipes, talk about beauty tips, talk about cereals, you know, that's what women want. And I looked at it and I said, really? Really? I don't watch these cereals, I don't like them. Can I rip them apart? So he said, okay. I said, yeah, I can rip them apart. I can say who sleeps in those satin night suits. I can't. It's just so uncomfortable. I can talk about the bindis of the vamp who dresses like that. I can do that if that's what you want me to do. So it's about negotiating. I can't even not talk to my programming head. But I have to find ways where I say that, you know, when you talk about women, stop using stereotypes, because that is so important. All of us here are different individuals, and somehow with women, you know, we forget that. We feel, acha, women matlab this color, this film, this music, this talk, which is not true. So, which is what, of course, I try to do. And also, like everywhere, you know, there's a notion that if you're a woman and if you have to speak to so many people, you have to be very polite and say, sir, aap chai lenge ya coffee? Sab theek hai. So also to sometimes kind of shake the status quo is part of my job. And if by doing that, I can make another person, another individual, another woman, another girl, feel comfortable in her skin, feel like she's not a tomboy. You don't have to use that phrase. It's okay. You can be a woman who doesn't like pink. It's as simple as that. You do not become a tomboy because you don't, or because, you know, you have some other likes and dislikes. So that is what it is. It's a great journey. It's a profession where no 2 days are the same. So I really enjoy that. And the fact that I get to be in such lovely gatherings, listening to such inspiring women, that just helps me with my content. Very, very simply.
And this is a room full of content then.
Absolutely. And I'm loving the view from here. So I was listening to everyone sitting there, but yahan se toh it's another feel.
Lovely. Thank you so much. Can we have a big round of applause? Nabenta, I think one thing that I've been sort of thinking about, and this is part of her job, when Garima was talking or when Lola was talking in the morning, you know, community sounds way too nice and way too magical. But the truth is, somewhere there is the dirty job of managing expectations. And I think the bigger your impact, the more difficult this job gets. Because once something starts working, people assume everything will work. And I'm sure that doesn't work out like that. So give us a sense of how you guys manage that at Clay, and, you know, your own sort of, you know, view on that.
Well, I would like to start by saying that I'm very honored and excited to be the summit today. And at Clay, we always focus on a lot of feedback concern, because we are dealing with young children, so a lot of parent feedback, being transparent, open to suggestions, and suggestions may also come to us in the form of complaints at times, that this is not going right, or this is how we can improvise. So we constantly work on that feedback and try and make things better for parents, because if the child is well settled at the daycare, the parent can easily work at office without having that guilt of leaving a child at a daycare. So within a span of 7 years, right from growing one center, right from one center to almost 120 centers, it has been a wonderful journey, and each one of us has learned a lot in the process, be it a teacher, be it a caregiver, be it a parent, and the focus is always the child, along with the focus on employees as well. So it has been a learning process throughout, and there have been ups and downs, and we've come a long way.
You're quite polite about your job, I have to say. I'm sure it's not as easy as you make it sound, but I agree that it's, the focus is on the child. So I think my learning from what you said is that focus on what's the most important reason why you're doing what you're doing.
Right.
And it is something that I think we as a team learn pretty much every single day. We have Vartika in the room, who is not only super young, but also super bright. So Vartika is an engineering student who's in a hurry. Actually, she reminds me of me when I was in college, because I was in a super hurry to start work. So I started work very early. I did my first startup very early. So I was chatting with Vartika. And so she runs the Women in Tech community on SHEROES, and she runs 2-3 other Women in Tech initiatives. She's going to tell us about it. But she's in a hurry. And, you know, it's amazing to see that kind of vibe. Vartika, tell us about your own initiative and the Women in Tech work that you do. And why do you do it? Like, you know, why can't you chill and go watch movies?
Well, first of all, I would like to thank SHEROES and Sairi for having me here. The very first thing that I would like to share is the learning that I have gained throughout. Life gives so many ups and downs, right? We are thrown with so many challenges. Then we have only two options. Either we can give up, or we can take charge of our own thing, because there are challenges when we find no one around us who can help us out, right? And then we feel like alone, that there is no one who is going to help me. And in that point of time, the main thing that you need to do is take charge and start helping your own self. And in the meantime, you'll gradually find someone who will definitely come on a way to help you out. But if you give up so early without taking the charge of your own self, then there's no one in the room or no one around who can help you out. This is what I have learned with my experiences so far. Now, coming to the background. Basically, I have a defense background. My dad was in Air Force, and he works on unmanned aerial vehicles. So I have a kind of tech background from the very childhood. And every weekend, we used to have some tech conversations with my dad. So the love for technology comes from there. And since my school days, I've been associated with so many communities. And I'm a kind of ambivert person, so I somewhat feel like there are so many stories that all of us have. But sometimes it happens that we are not sure whom to share it with. Or we are not open up about all those stories, right? Because we feel that if we share these stories to that person is not going to understand what I want to share. So we need to kind of form a community of like-minded people where everyone can share the stories and everyone can understand the perspective of that particular idea, right? So the love for community comes from my school days. Now, gradually, when I entered into my 11th standard, I took up computer science, and I built a very first website, a basic website, and I felt like I defeated Google. That was the feeling I had, that I defeated Google. It's doing everything that I wanted it to do. So then I moved into college, and in second year, I attended one Women Tech Makers event, and I saw Sairi there, and it's been like 2 years from then. I at that moment I decided that this is the lady I wanna personally interact with at least once in my life. Seriously, that was the feeling.
So damn determined.
I was just one of the attendee at that event, and it's been 2 years. I just found out that, okay, if I have to get to the Sairi, I have to be get connected with communities. Now, how to get connected with communities? I just figure out that Microsoft program, that is Microsoft Student Partner Program. So I just got selected for Microsoft Student Partner, and that's a very big community worldwide. So from there, that was actually, the Microsoft was actually the turning point for me as a community person. And since then, we have done a lot and lot of tech evangelism, empowering more and more students in tech in the form of workshops, tech talks, hands-on sessions, and so much. And this program also helped me in my personal career as well. And due to this, we have started working on a project which is for heart blockage patients. And my aim with this project is to, like, what I want is this project should be built by entirely a women-only team. That's what I want, right? So, and then this project was also selected by Microsoft as a global level at the world top 50 teams. And so these were the motivation points that I had. And all of these things I could do only because of my love for the communities and tech communities. And through, like, while in this journey, I just figured out after my tech talks, when I used to step down out of the stage, the students from first year, second year used to just come to me and ask one simple question, a very common question. I want to do something, but I don't know what. How many of you are students here? How many of you faced this question or had this question at any point of your life? I want to do something, but I don't know what. This is a very common question that students generally have in their first year and second year. And in my tech career, I had the same problem in my first year and second year. So I just realized that students waste these 2 years figuring out there are so many technologies around, what should I pick up? What should I choose as a career, right? And then when they realize in the third year that, yes, this is what I want to do, they don't have enough time to experience, to experiment, and the placement times comes, right? So they don't have at that point of time something built in their hand and to show to the company, right? So from there, the idea came, okay, this is a common problem. So I started a community that is Code Sharp to help these kind of people, and in the form of tech talks, connecting them with the industry experience from Microsoft, Google, Amazon, and all those, because I have some strong network with all these people. So they are ready to deliver these talks free of cost to the students. And the certification courses that are there in, like, for example, 20,000 course, they are ready to give that course for free of cost. So basically aim to provide all the technologies at one place for them, because what happens today, I'm attending one event. I'll at the end of the event, I'll be like, this is the technology I want to take. Tomorrow I'll be attending another event and I'll be like, okay, this is the technology I want to take. And this confusion goes on. So we'll be providing all the technologies for them. We have recently covered 6 week summer training as well, training students on data science as well as .NET and so many other technologies. So this is the main agenda, to help these students because they really need it. And apart from that, now we are expanding and we are reaching out to school students. The reason being, in foreign countries, we have observed that right from the 7th or 8th standards, students start building their own websites. And there is no need to have any higher, this website building in the curriculum. But in India, if we start, like, let's just imagine if we start having the developers, the website builders, at least from basic website builders from the school level, what will be the impact of developer community in India? Right, so we are gradually trying to expand it to school students, help them out with the very basic programming things. And I would request all the mothers here that when we expand this, please stay tuned with us and
send your children
to our workshops and courses. It will be very beneficial for them.
Super. So. Thank you so much, Vartika. Who's feeling inspired? All right. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a few questions. I have lots of them for the ladies, but I'm going to be nice and open it up for everyone here. So think up a few questions that you might have. Otherwise, I will keep talking. And I'm going to set up a university called the SHEROES University and make you the principal, Vartika, to run it. I think you take charge more than I have ever done in any conversation. So clearly you're a real SHEROES. Any questions for the panel here? All right, ma'am, you have a question. We'll get you a mic, hold on.
Please bear with my ignorance.
No.
Is SHEROES a non-profit?
No, not at all.
Okay, and if it, I mean, you answered that, how do you make your money? I mean, how do we get funded? Economically viable?
Right, so our model is pretty simple. We are a consumer internet platform, which means we are pretty much like Pinterest, Twitter, Instagram, Snap, you know, and SHEROES runs on what we call enterprise businesses, which means we serve needs of enterprises via various services that we offer to them, remote work, diversity, corporate helplines and support, and of course working with CMOs on crafting brand solutions. So our business model is enterprise, our product is consumer internet. Shipra, you have a question.
Hi, my name is Shipra. I wanted to know what were the challenges that all of you faced when you build communities, right? It's a step forward into the unknown. You don't know the people you're interacting with. It takes time to build traction. You know, how did you build the noise for yourself so that people come and participate?
Swarnima, you want to take that? You just did something that made noise.
Yeah. Thank you. Actually, I run a women's health community. Now, the biggest challenge I ran into was, you know, letting women know that there are issues that they, you know, they're probably living with, but they don't know. You know, there are so many times we are just told that, hey, you know what, period pain is very, very normal. But sometimes that is the single most important symptom for something or the other. Sometimes, you know. So for me, the biggest challenge was getting women to really think that if you have a problem, you should talk about it, if not to a gynecologist, then to a friend or to an informed community. The second thing that I personally did with my organization was that I personally traveled to tier two cities. And in tier one and tier two cities, we don't really know what women's needs are, you know. I must thank SHEROES for creating an ecosystem where people are talking about more than just fashion and beauty, which is considered to be the only market traditionally for women. But it's very important to open up that market. So I traveled to tier one and tier two cities. I interacted with women who were, sort of assembled through my personal contacts there. And I just wanted to know what their day was like. You know, what were their challenges? What was their emotional labor like? What was the mental load like? And I personally did these communications and conversations, and little by little, word spread, and we were able to build our community. And like Sairi said, recently we conducted the country's first women's health festival, FemCon, which also marked our first birthday as an organization. So we learn from communities like these, which are really creating an ecosystem, you know. That's what
we're doing. Thank you for sharing that. And may I add that one of the things we're doing at SHEROES is partnering with community creators to offer the SHEROES platform. So our job is not to nurture communities that are run by us. We're very happy to open the platform to any community that you want to build on top of it. And it just brings more value to our existing members. And you get access to a more richer cleaner, more focused audience. There are a lot of people doing that. We have She Drives Data that runs on SHEROES, Namita Naya runs it, and many other communities now have found a home on SHEROES because it's a women-only safe space and it's part of that mix. I know we are out of time, but thank you, ladies, for being part of this wonderful, wonderful conversation. I hope people who have questions for you will come up and chat with you, but keep doing the great work that you do and keep rocking. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Oh, wow.
Okay, the DJ doesn't want me to talk. The party is almost getting started. Communities connect the dots. Women build each other up. They build safe spaces, go beyond and transform these communities. Ask yourself and you shall find the answers. Leave your fears behind. Not welfare projects. It's about negotiating to find your way. Entrepreneur, blogger, educator, jockey. Community builder, influencer. Empowered, powerful, shining. Women aren't stereotypes. That's an absolute myth. Labels are a useless farce. It's about the spotlight on your work. With women as owners of tech and more, so many women, so many journeys, so many stories, all empowering lives. Thank you so much, ladies, for that community panel.